Do you think the machine will ever be finished?
Do I think the machine will ever be finished? Oh yeah. Oh yeah. We're getting, I think the pressure is on, and we've gone from kind of idealistic design to very practical and quick design whenever possible. You know, there are always things that will come back that need help, like the marble releases, things that musically don't end up working need to be redesigned. But yeah, I think it'll be finished, and I think it will be finished probably, you know, a couple months. I don't doubt it will be done pretty soon.
A couple months? Well, great. Wilson, can you write down the date of today and we can check this statement later? Thank you. So happy to introduce Dr. Phil to you all. He's a long-term member of the MMX project, and I think he said something that I related to so very much. He like summarized what you have been seeing the last 2 years. He said that we have gone from idealistic design to practical design. Basically, what you have witnessed is like a vision meeting reality. When I started this project, I had a kind of idea that as long as you tweak something, you can always make it work. Everything is possible. Believe in yourself. Now my childlike perspective of a wondrous world has been beaten down by engineering reality. What's cool with this project is that we're taking a high-flying vision and we just have to make it work. A very recent and famous example of a project where they succeeded to take a vision and combine it with reality is a Cybertruck from Tesla. With the work-hardened stainless steel exoskeleton design, they combined this vision of a sci-fi movie-looking truck with a practical to use and practical to manufacture truck. I'm very ignorant about cars, but from a problem solving perspective, what I can tell, it's just brilliant.
If you're interested in a less ignorant design discussion on the Cybertruck, the Design Prototype Test YouTube channel has an amazing series on this topic. And if you're interested in a more general discussion about the Tesla mission, I can recommend the Now You Know YouTube channel.
Let's try to do something similar with the Cyberbase. In today's video, we're going to discuss two things. First half is about how the marbles can hit the bass strings in a good way. Second in this video, I want to discuss these parts. It's about how the marbles can be released up here.
I'm Philip Brown. I'm an assistant professor of biomedical engineering at Wake Forest University. That's in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, on the east coast of the US. I study surgical biomechanics and I help make medical devices, tools that help surgeons and doctors do what they need to do. Yeah, I've been 3D printing for a really long time, maybe 12 years or so. So Martin gave me a challenge, which was to redesign the essentially the reflector plate of the base, which is the component that will guide the marbles as they come into the string and guide the marbles as they leave the string and go into the funnel. I have a base at home that I dismantled a bit and started to fiddle around with, and I was thinking that one of the objectives, original objectives, was to see the marbles come into the strings and leave the strings. So that meant there couldn't be any walls. A thought we had was to make the floor of the where the marbles hit slanted on two edges, kind of like this. You have a spring in the middle, you have the two edges, the marble comes in and it just kind of gets wedged in between these two faces and then launches out. So I printed that out, It looked really cool. You probably saw it in an earlier video, but it didn't work very well. What ended up happening was the marble would hit the string and one of those edges and not the other one. And so it'd come in and it'd launch off the side. And it was very unpredictable as to which side it would go off on. Redesign number two, which was like, okay, let's use those faces again, but let's put little walls on them and maybe we'll make those like plexiglass or something. And so that was version two. Those worked pretty well. The marble would come in and bounce out. And on that plate, while it had those little walls, it also had some design to let marbles like travel down the plate if they didn't get good contact. So that one looked even cooler, worked only marginally better. around that time, I think Martin put Carlos and I together to do some more collaborative designing. We settled upon kind of to do a better version or more engineered version of the fins that you saw on the first Winter Garden marble machine. And those have a fin. They have like a little bracket arm to attach things to. And the idea of that was to allow this fin to be able to move in a couple different degrees of freedom so that we can get like the positioning between the fins to be right, allow for the marble to come in at a precise angle, leave at a precise angle. And so these fins need to be able to have slight adjustment. And we printed that one. We actually printed that in metal. You know, why print this in metal? You could machine it or you could, and that's a very good question. We did it because we had the opportunity to do it and it's really cool. Sometimes you just have to do it because you can. As you have seen from a earlier Winter Garden Wednesdays video, the legs did not come out particularly strong. They broke along some weak points. It was really hard to guess that would happen without printing it and testing it. So I came up with a couple more versions of how to fix that. They were much more rigid, which helps both with the printing process and with the with its durability. Yeah, so the final part still has the ability to adjust along the string so that we can get the fanning. We adjusted the angle with a base plate that has slight angles on it, so they're each face where a fin sits is slightly angled.
This is the beautiful 3D print from Phil. This is how I thought all 3D prints would look like before I started trying myself. You can see that he even printed M3 threads in here. On top of the base comes these fins. So I really think they're beautiful, well done. So from the front here, you can see that the base has a curved top to make the wings flare out to the sides. I want to discuss that. This is the 4 base strings, 8 marble drops to reach a very tiny area, 4 hit points is a very tricky problem to solve, and this is what we had from the beginning. The distance between the strings is 22 millimeters, and the original marble releases were wider than 22, so the release came from the side in at an angle down on the base strings. However, with a new tighter matrix sentinel release design, I managed to cramp them in within 22 millimeters. This is the marble shuttle for the drum channels. And as you can see, for the bass channels, they're much tighter. So if we do a smooth pan up, just like that, we can now see that this flaring of the wings outside like this by having the bass curved was only necessary in the earlier scenario, and I have actually designed away the need for this. So Phil's perfect print is now going to get a Martin modification just like any other professional made part in the Marble Machine project. So the highest honor in the Marble Machine X project is to send me a professionally designed and manufactured part only to sit at home and see me butcher it. If I butcher your part, it means I like you. Space circles! This print machined really well. Zero problems. Ships looks good. Easy. Did you know that there's actually people who believe that this print is flat? So the cyber wings are now perpendicular to each other, and we're ready to follow through with this compact marble drop design. I need a way to hold the bass guitar while I'm working on it, and I realize I have a custom-made stand here. I taped a temporary marble drop. Let's see. That was actually first try. I did not even direct these. And this is what I found with these fins. They do a really good job. Like, the bounce is super consistent. The marble hit my hand at the same spot every time. Slow-mo! Now we need to shift our focus from down here to up here. Let's look at my redesign.
So no, those are not icicles or elephant feet. This is the base release. Here we have 8 releases. You can see the 8 holes on top here where the PMMA pipes goes in. There's a lot of things going on in the inside. And we can switch to an analysis from the side like this. All these metal parts are going to be laser cut. And here we come to the moving parts. And this is how I managed to make the marble shuttles thin enough to be within 22 millimeter. I used these steel side, as you can see here. That's all the metal parts. Here comes the plywood parts. You can see how the bottom goes here with a hole for the marble there. So all the metal parts are ordered and I could make the cam for all these plywood parts. All the lines here is the tool paths, and for this whole project there was a lot of tool paths involved. And we have also a lot of features like these, the holes from the side, and especially in these pieces I wanted to drill and pilot drill the holes on the CNC to have an accurate assembly once the metal part arrive. Normally I love designing in CAD, but this time it was tough. It took a long time. I was slow. You can kind of see it on some of the parts that I'm like, ah. I'm not using tabs because the chips holds the pieces in place pretty good, and then there's less work afterwards.
You won't believe this, but I actually messed these marble shuttles up. So you can see that the marble should go through here easily and it doesn't. The hole is too small because I missed a little treasured tick box in the toolpath called stock to leave. So the machine left a little stock here as if it was a roughing operation and not a finishing operation. So now we have to enlarge these holes. So first of all, we have to remember that we're in stoic training and any setback is an adventure, okay? So attitude fixed. Now we have to fix the workpiece. So bump it up against here, press it down and clamp it stuck. Second thing we have to fix is to find the center of this hole. So basically I'm just going to line this up visually and I'm going to reduce the speed of the manual jog to 2% from 7. So when I move it sideways, you can see it moves very slowly. A little bit this way. You can see the step drill is in contact with the wall. So now I will leave the machine here and now I can zero the X and zero the Y. So now the machine knows where the center of the hole is. I can look for my G-code in the screw up folder, 18 millimeter, load. There's one more thing I need to tell the machine, and that's where the surface is. I'm slowly going down to the surface till I feel it touching. I'm zeroing the C axis, that's the up and down axis. So just to make it obvious, you can see that the marble is not going through. You could hear of the sound of the cut that it sounded pretty concentric. It was the same sound everywhere. The marble goes straight through. I can unlock this, put the next piece straight in, bump it up, clamp it down. So this setup will actually also work to do some extra features here. I'm gonna remove the radius here and then pilot drill for these vertical L hooks. So here's first the radius. And now we can repeat this easily.
So there's a certain hole combination on this side, and on the other side is another hole combination.
Let's go fancy and also make the countersink on the CNC.
So after all that heavy designing, it was a really nice feeling to start to cut the pieces on the CNC machine. Now when all the pieces are done, we just have to wait for the metal parts, and I can't actually push this assembly further. We have the marble guiding fins designed by Phil, but on the base what we have is actually only 3D printed placeholders. We would want them in stainless steel. So if you would like to manufacture the cyber wings for the cyber base, I leave a Google form in the description of this video so you can let us know. I want to say a big thanks to Philip Brown for your constant support of the Marble Machine X project and your beautiful designs and your prediction of the couple months finishing time. A huge thanks also to Carlos Montoro, the luthier from Anjuda Guitars, who has customized this bass. So huge thanks to everyone who are supporting this project. I am actually going to tease one thing in the end of this video. There's a special sub-assembly that has been in the works behind the scenes for a long, long time, and this is how it looks, and this is a work in progress, but we are getting there. More on that later. I also wanted to show you something amazing. Check this out. That's the Marble Machine, that's the Marble Machine, and that's also the Marble Machine. A carbon copy in another scale in Lego, built by Zach. I just had to show you this. Thanks, Zach, for sending this. So cool. You're an amazing designer.
Do I think the machine will ever be finished? Oh yeah.